Hey guys, Hobbs here. Welcome to my level 100 either attempt or actual ding. I don't want to ruin the surprise as of yet. Earlier today, I showed you attempt number one, which I think is worth watching. It was a huge pull, but that place started to get camped. I wasn't able to find any mobs, so here I'm pulling a variety of mobs. Unfortunately, you will see some evading. The evading is quite low. I find that they don't path as much like as far as they used to be. It would be great if they could, you know, as long as you had aggro, and then once in a while you'll get a certain mob that follows you to the end of time. I don't know what the logic is, but if I could figure out, it would be great. You'll see some core hounds in the distance. My guild came to watch, so they might actually have some footage that they're going to send to me from their point of view. This one I had a rare involved, which is great, so I kept pulling him because I thought, how cool would it be to have a big mass AoE pull plus a rare and try to get everything kind of AoE down at once. This one was quite challenging again because, look, at lay hands, I was very low in health. I always save it to the last minute for the simple fact is I might need, you know, I might go through the 100% again, and I want to make sure that I do the full pull as possible. And plus, you'll see in the top right hand corners where I have my experience, I'm just about to ding. So I'm pulling more mobs, trying to get this thing as big as possible, because all I need is one. And plus, the challenge wasn't here. It was like, I'm not dying fast enough. Like, the first pull I felt I did earlier today was a lot more powerful. At this point, I'm like, meh, I'm going to live. I like being at the edge of my seat for the whole thing, because then when I ding, I get the full level up. Now, I still am pretty well down 3/4, but I want to see it so that, you know, when it goes, I might be down to 10% or something challenging where I'm almost dead. But now, because that mob kept coming back, honestly, my momentum went down. I'm like, oh no, here I go, I'm going to ding at the last minute, but at the same time, I'm too close to it to run. He evades for a third time, maybe fourth time, I don't know how much. This one was very, very frustrating. The only thing cool is I am kind of dead, so I'm like, well, I kind of kept it going. It kind of turned into, instead of a mass AoE pull, a mass AoE converted into a chain pull, and now it looks like I got a hunter who's not part of the guild come in, and he's downing this boss as well. I'm looking for something else to add to it, and there's really nothing. So at this time, I'm like, okay, I've been going all night. For those who saw the first video, I had about 1,000 people watching. Some had left because it took so long for me to find the perfect camp spot. I wanted to make sure that this was epic for you guys, and here we were, this last boss, thinking, well, hey, it's going to be on a rare, which is good. Looking forward to the loot. He's got a couple little adds. And here we go, guys. Here we go. Look at this. We got just a tad more experience. I'm still looking for something, but I don't see anything. Just, I wanted to add something for the last pull. I hope you're still watching, because and look, I didn't even ding, and I'm like, oh great, now it's going to be on one of these little void oozes. I'm going to ding on the void ooze. But then when I realized I didn't, I left that void ooze, and I'm like, you know what? I'm going to make the ding fantastic like I always have. I am going to come out with part 3, guys. That one was just an attempt. I wanted to keep the momentum up, because if you haven't seen attempt 1, I'm going to have it in the link below. And then, guys, coming out later on today will be either attempt number 3 or the actual ding. Now, skipping ahead, I want to show you my first dungeon when I was level 100. I wanted to test it out. I didn't know how big a pull I could do or how small of a pull, but I wanted to give the healer a chance to see, to use some of the healer tricks, because obviously we want to see if they're going to be able to handle the mass AoE pulls, and this is also guild run, so we'll be able to, you know, they'll be able to. It's kind of like a stress test, let's put it that way. I'm going to show you guys the live reaction as I do this, because I think that was half the fun of it. So these ones we can avoid, but we're not going to. Might as well grab. I'm going to grab these guys too. I'm going to give my healer a heart attack here. Just kind of going to run out of line of sight here for a moment. I shouldn't be doing this, but whatever. Just gonna drive her nuts for a second. Then I'm gonna run over here and drive her nuts again. She won't be able to find me. Where's my healer? There we go, I lay hands. Sorry! This is what you get. Okay. Hopefully my healer now heals me. Okay, there we go. We got her. Oh, shoot. Nice heals. I think I was standing something. How's the healer doing? She's not out of mana yet, which is good. There we go, that was a good little pull. There we go. 571. See, I don't think any greens are going to upgrade me, no. Probably shouldn't have disenchanted that. Very well done. That was good. I used the lay hands. That was good. Good heals, by the way. Great heals.
Well, guys, if you enjoyed this, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you'll be the first to be notified when I bring out more. Tons of new footage coming out. Another attempt or actual ding to come out later on today. And, guys, as long as you keep watching The Hobbs Way of Poland, I'll keep making it. Thanks again. Till next time.